So, today I'll show you how you can avoid the spam folder, one of the biggest threats to your outbound process. Why? Well, because we all want one thing, for our messages to reach the prospect's inbox. However, with the nature of sales or outreach emails and the words that are typically used in them, sometimes those messages can easily end up in the spam folder. Firstly, we need to get our mindset right if we want to overcome all spam filters. What I mean by that is we should get to the core, the essence of what they are. For example, I didn't realize that there is no one universal algorithm that lets messages get to the main inbox. The more email providers, the more unique spam filtering algorithms there are. This means that your email may get to some of your prospects, but not to others. But you may have already thought about that. So let's dig a little deeper. What is the goal of the spam folder? Naturally, to protect users from dangerous messages and to keep inboxes uncluttered. We've all seen, or at least heard about malicious emails. So from that, we can extract our first rule: avoid writing similar ones. Now, it may sound simple, but as a famous Leonardo once said, simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. But what are the actual specific factors that spam filters look at while judging our message? Let's go through some of the most important ones. Number one, checking if the message wasn't open before getting to the recipient. Number two, words typically used by spammers in the actual email copy. Number three, the status of the sender's email address, especially if it hasn't been blacklisted. Number four, the number of links in the email body and if those links actually work and aren't just broken. And number five, the sender's historical engagement rate data. For each of the factors on this list, and even more that only the people who actually programmed the algorithms know about, you score points. But here's an important note. You actually don't want to aim high. You want the score to be as low as possible. The higher the score, the greater the chances of landing in the spam folder. So because of all that, and the fact that those filters aren't perfect, and sometimes they can put a real, legitimate email into the spam folder, or vice versa, it's very important for you to know how this whole process works. And now, let's get to the practical part. What are some actionable steps you can take in order to keep your messages away from the spam folder? Number one, make sure your technical setup is just right. Before anything else, make sure you've set up your SPF and DKIM records. These are necessary for your message to be identified correctly. Now, if you're unsure about these, we've got videos on both, so you can check them out by clicking in the card right now. Also, some email automation software, like Woodpecker, can tell you if your settings are actually correct. So if you're a beginner or you just want a quick and easy solution, you can definitely give that a try. Number two, change or remove spam triggering words. Now we can move on to your email copy. You don't want to sound like a scammer, so what are some actual specific words and phrases you should avoid? Most importantly, words related to money, so cash, profit, but also contests and winning them, but even marketing. That's why marketers of any kind can have real problems with spam filters. Now, including a simple congratulations or talking about your favorite anti-aging cream shouldn't automatically discard your message, but add a few more dollar signs and you may be in trouble. So it's necessary for you to compare the words you use in your future messages with longer, comprehensive lists of dangerous phrases and limit their use to the absolute minimum. Number three, diversify your emails. If you're sending a bunch of messages, for example cold emails, you may want to diversify their content, even just a little bit, so your email provider doesn't get suspicious. After all, this is exactly what spammers do: send the exact same message to a lot of people. Again, that's something that email automation can help you with. Coming back to Woodpecker, it features customizable text fields called snippets, which are really easy to use and may even increase your reply rate through personalization on top of helping you overcome spam filters. Number four, don't send all emails at once. Do you know what's another typical spammer behavior and why newsletters always get put into the updates tab? Well, it's quite simple actually. It's because of sending all emails at once. In the case of newsletters, it makes sense. But if you want every single one of your prospects to reply to you, that's not really the best outcome. Not to mention the star of this video, the spam folder. If you're sending emails manually, you are pretty much in the clear. After all, it takes a while to type up a message. However, looking back at step number three, just remember to not copy and paste the exact same message to each and every one of your recipients. And if you're using email automation software, make sure it's designed for cold emails and not newsletters. Woodpecker sends your emails in random intervals between 90 and 140 seconds at the maximum. This mimics human behavior and in turn helps your messages out a lot. So if you follow all those steps and keep in mind the essence of spam filters, you will be drastically increasing the chances of getting into your prospect's main inbox. Also, one final tip before I go is that you can always test the waters by sending a small batch of emails first and seeing if they perform as they should. But either way, I wish you the best of luck and great reply rates.